That's it?
Be careful, everyone!
That's it?
Say your prayers.
Ray thrust!
You're too weak.
Say your prayers.
Hellhammer! Hellhammer! Hellhammer!
You're too weak. You're too weak.
What's that?
It's Ventus's core.
That's the fake sylph.
Didn't you all defeat it last time?
No, that is Ventus.
What do you mean? So it's not the fake sylph?
Its form may be different, but its aura most certainly belongs to Ventus.
What should we do? With that thing there, we can't get anywhere near the Centurion's core.
We'll have to retrieve it by force. There is no other choice.
Again? I sometimes wish Ratatusk would just possess me all the time so I wouldn't be afraid.
It's over!
No! Oh, healing power? healing power.
Have it
strike! Oh, healing power.
Don't work! Move!
Oh no!
Move!
Red thrust! Oh, healing power! Hammer!
It's over!
Be grateful.
Oh, healing power.
Damn it.
Power casting.
Fine.
Thanks.
Move. Don't just use art.
But this is more fun.
Of course I won.
You said that was the fake Sylph you guys defeated before, right? I wonder why it came back to life.
Sylph's imposter must have come to life due to the dormant state of the Centurion's core. Although it lost its power when you defeated it, I assume the core caused the beast to be reborn after enough time had passed.
So the winds in Asgard will die down now?
Once we hatch Ventus.
I'll go get it. Stop! It's dangerous! What is?
When Centurions are in a core state, they're dormant. During that time, their power is out of their control. They can attract monsters and cause abnormalities in nature, even disasters. It's impossible for human beings to maintain their sanity while in contact with such a powerful being.
What? If a normal person holds a Centurion's core, they get drawn into its chaos and their mind is destroyed. Which is why you shouldn't even think about touching it. I see. I'm sorry I didn't ask you first, but what about you, Marta? I have Ratatosk's protection. I'll be fine. Anyway, it doesn't take long to hatch.
All right, Lady Marta, please release the Centurion's core.
Right.
Ventus has awoken. As Ventus's powers return, as a knight of Ratatosk, Emil should also awaken to new powers.
Don't we have to befriend some monsters to get the Centurion's power back?
Right. Ventus is the Centurion of Wind, so we need to get Wind Elemental monsters to join us.
Please don't forget Darkness Elemental monsters as well. I'd like for my powers to return.
I know.
Thank you. Won't work!
That was easy! Put an end to the gusts.
Nice work, Marta.
Yes, all of our hard work paid off. Colette, are you okay? You look a bit down.
Huh? Are you worried about touching the core?
There's no need to worry. Touching the core for only such a short time shouldn't...
That's not it. I'm not worried about me. It's about Lloyd. He's collecting Centurion's cores, right? That would mean...
Colette, we're after Lloyd. We don't know where the Centurion's cores are, but if we follow Lloyd, he's sure to take us to them. That's why you should come with us. And when we find Lloyd, you can warn him about how dangerous it is.
Thank you, Emil, but I'm gonna go my own way from here on out.
Why? If you're looking for Lloyd...
Lloyd has a Rayard, a type of machine that can fly in the sky. So I might not be able to catch up with them on foot. That's why I'm gonna go look for Lloyd by air, like this.
Okay.
Colette.
So, I just wanted to say that I'm sorry for everything. I can never make it up to you, but... I want to do everything I can.
Don't apologize anymore. I mean, honestly, I can't forgive you for what happened to my mother. But as soon as I saw you, I knew you never meant for that to happen to Palma Costa.
Marta!
I've never met anyone as kind and caring as you.
Thank you.
We're friends, right?
Right.
What a lovely scene.
Not that I disagree, but things like that make you sound stuffy.
Do you think it would be okay if I went with you two to see the mayor before we part?
Of course. Right, Emil?
Sure, let's go.
So, Tenenby, you're a Centurion, right? What exactly makes a Centurion anyway?
Allow me to explain. We Centurions, numbering 8 in total, are the faithful servants of Lord Ratatosk, the Lord of all monsters. We each belong to a particular element, and with the aid of the monsters under our control, we monitor the levels of mana in the world. You might call us the guardians of the world's mana.
That sounds sort of like the Symphonian 8.
Hey, I remember that. That's the story of the 8 warriors blessed by the spirits. Who fought against the sinister Dark Five, right?
That's right. And the Dark Five's leader turned out to be the long-lost father of Symphonia Red.
I used to love that story when I was young.
So that would make Tenenby Symphonia Black.
What? You mean that story was based on the Centurions? Tenebrae, that's so cool!
Does anyone else notice how the conversation gets waylaid as soon as Colette joins? Or is it just me?
So the stone dais is safe once again. You have our gratitude.
Not at all. I'm just happy that I could help.
And you too. Thank you for lending your efforts along with the Chosen for our town.
It was nothing.
Excuse me, Mayor. What happened to the Vanguard?
Most of them have left town, but it would be a good idea to stay cautious. I'm ashamed to admit it. But the Vanguard's extreme ideology has begun to influence the people of our town. More and more people have turned their backs on the Chosen and the Goddess Martell. It's truly disgraceful.
There's too much of a gap between the technological level of Tetha Alla and Silverant. The liberation of Silverant advocated by the Vanguard must sound very appealing.
The Church of Martell has become biased toward Tetha Alla as well. I'm sorry. If only I was more effective.
No, that's not it at all. Chosen One, you saved our town twice now. Please don't blame yourself for what has happened.
Well then, I've got to get going. Thank you both so much.
You're leaving already?
I'm really worried about Lloyd. Watch out for the Vanguard. You be careful too.
I look forward to the day when we may meet again.
Thank you, Tenneby. See you later. Alright, we should get going too.
Right. So where to?
Well, I was thinking we might be able to get some information if we went to Lloyd's hometown.
You mean Azalea?
That will require us to find passage on a boat.
Right. So I think we should head to Palma Costa.
Okay, I'm fine with that.
Shall we depart then?
Colette is the Chosen of Regeneration. She didn't act aloof at all. She's actually pretty down to earth.
If by down to earth you mean ditzy, then yeah.
Okay, maybe she's a little spacey, but there's something soothing about her.
Oh, so she soothed you, did she?
I just found it easy to relax around her.
That sounds like soothing to me.
Why are you getting so angry?
Who says I'm angry? It's hard to get around Hakonasia with all these hills.
Yeah, I know.
When you moved to Luin, didn't you pass by Hakonasia Peak?
We did, but I was inside a carriage, so I don't really remember it.
A carriage, huh? I get motion sickness, so I never ride in those.
You mean you've done all this traveling on foot?
Well, I started riding from time to time after I met up with Tenebrae.
Wait, I thought you just said you got sick riding in carriages.
No, I meant riding on Tenebrae. You're a good cook.
I wouldn't say good. Probably about average.
Don't be so modest. This is really tasty.
Thanks. I had to help out in the kitchen at home. Guess I must have picked up a few things along the way.
I must say, you humans do eat the most peculiar things.
Well, what do you usually eat, Tenebrae?
I absorb mana naturally, so I have no need to consume food. We Centurions are highly refined life forms, after all.
Not being able to eat would be no fun at all.
I agree.
messenger has just informed us that the Chosen is headed in the direction of Luin.
Aww, Dex is in charge of that area. That's no fun. Guess that means we should just concentrate on the Centurion's cores.
Ma'am, you should also know that it appears Lady Marta is headed in this direction.
Oh, Mart's coming? Then I'll leave the Centurion's cores to you, Hockey. I'll go and set up a nice ambush for our sweet little Mart when she gets to Palma Costa.
Marta, did you just hear that?
There's no choice. We'll go to Palma Costa and just do our best to steer clear of Alice.
Okay. Marta.
What just happened?
I don't know. I had a weird vision all of a sudden. Maybe it was a dream.
A dream? While you were wide awake and walking around? You want to rest a bit?
No, I'm fine. Let's go.
Are you sure?
His color seems to be mostly back. It's probably safe to keep going.
See? Tenebrae thinks I'm fine too.
All right then. But tell us if you aren't feeling well again.
Getting close to Palma Costa.
Yeah.
It's been 6 months. It's the same for you, right?
About that, yeah.
I'll bet you're looking forward to seeing your old friends again.
My old friends?
Emil, what's wrong?
What? Oh, nothing.
What is it? You kids want to see old Colton's collection, too?
Your collection?
You don't? Then get out! What a shame. That young lass is quite the looker. Could have passed the time showing her a thing or two until Richter got back.
Richter's coming here?
You know that scoundrel?
Scoundrel? Sounds like Richter, all right.
Marta.
When are you expecting him?
Should be here any minute now. Actually, he's late. He must be having a hell of a time finding that Tower of Mana Mirror.
What's that?
Out of my face, boy. I have nothing to tell you.
You can tell me.
So this Richter feller comes in and tells me to hand over this spiritual tome I worked so hard to get. I told him I'll trade it for the mirror and the Balakruff tombstone.
The spiritual tome? What's that?
I've never heard of it.
A book that wouldn't mean a damn to a couple of ignorant punks like you two. I've had enough of you, so now get out!
Thank you.
been 6 months.
Let's not get sentimental. We need to find out if Lloyd's come through here first, right?
Yeah, you're right.
We both know the town, so let's split up. We can meet at the pub.
But watch out for Alice.
Oh, right. Tenebrae, can you keep an eye on Emile?
That's not what I meant.
No, it's okay. See you later.
Well then, shall we get started?
Are you sure? Marta is the one with Ratatosk's core. And I'm supposed to be protecting her, not the other way around.
I'm able to easily sense where Lady Marta is at any time because she has the core. Frankly, I'm more concerned about you.
I'm so pathetic. I need to try harder. Really scare that easily?
Roar!
I'd say so.
There's that spiteful sight again.